Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to System of a Down song Aerials. This is a Patreon request by our patron Robert M, and we are back with System of a Down one more time.
Yeah, it's just a couple of days or 3 days since our last reaction, to be honest.
Streamline.
And we are very happy to react to System of a Down once again. We have reacted to one of their biggest hits a couple of months or so ago.
Chop Suey.
Chop Suey. And then we reacted to one just 3 days ago. And now we are reacting to Aerials. The names are really nice.
Yeah, all they're one word. Yeah.
All one word, and by itself, you know, is worthy of discussion.
Yeah.
Each of them by itself you can discuss, even without hearing the song.
I know.
So that's something nice about System of a Down by itself. Not too many musicians out there who just by the title of the song you can have a discussion.
True.
But System of a Down so far, the third song, early days, definitely
for
on
us.
Enoma. But it does seem like they put some thought into the titles.
I know, exact title.
Let's see if that much thought has also gone into the lyrics of the song and the music. Let's get started with our first time single take honest reaction for our patron. Robert M. Let's get started. It's a pure reaction by Kirti. You can find out what that means on our Patreon page, where there's a lot about us in our intro video as well as in the profile below that one. Below it. Aerials, System of a Down.
Thank you.
that sitar-like sound at the end.
Yeah, some bell, something.
Yeah, something like that. Not clear. I don't think it was a sitar, but something.
No, it wasn't a sitar, but there are other instruments also. There is santoor, and there are so many things that, you know, bring different sounds. Wow, this was great.
This was well sung. The vocals were really interesting. It was nice, refreshing, beautifully done. Great music. The guitar riffs were amazing. Very recognizable. Very System of a Down, so to speak.
Very System of a Down.
Yeah. You can tell that they have that.
Yeah.
They have that pattern in their music, and it's very refreshing, very unique.
Yeah.
And it's something that very rarely you get to hear
in
other
ambiguity.
Bands. So there's something nice about
that. That shows confidence of a band when you know your music.
Lot of skill. You know, they probably have a lot of skill in their guitars, guitar players' repertoire. And it could be seen in this third reaction that we're doing on this. Yeah, beautiful song. Very pertinent lyrics, pretty important lessons of wisdom in them. Pearls of wisdom, just like droplets of the waterfall. Wow, this was nice. This was really, really nice. Kirti, what are your initial thoughts and feelings? And then we'll dig deep into the lyrics of the song.
Yeah, it is one of those songs where I can definitely say, I can very clearly say, I like the lyrics, I like the vocals, and I like the instrumentals. So I like all three of them. There is nothing that is falling short in here in this song. Sometimes something or the other disappoints us, but this one, not disappointing on any of these fronts. I love this song. There was one vocalist. He was singing. Then they came two in the middle. And then it switched from that person to the next person so beautifully. It just flew down to him without even making people realize a major change in it. I like that. And I hope I'm right when I say that. I do realize the first vocalist, and then both of them merged together, and then the other one continued the song. So they have great vocal lineup.
Yeah, from what I gather in the lyrics, or what my understanding of it on the first listen is that it's pretty intense, it's pretty profound.
Yeah.
You can easily gain a few lessons. And, one of the first lessons I got right away after the first verse itself was, that's when the chorus started, Aerials in the Sky, when you lose small mind, you free your life. I kind of gathered the first lesson, which is about opening up your mind, you know, being more accepting, looking at the broader picture, the bigger picture, stepping out of your comfort zone, not having a small thinking, a small mindset, if I can call it that. So opening your mind, broadening your horizons, stepping out of your comfort zone. Most of us have this 2 to 2.5 feet bubble around us. It's invisible, but it's also termed as our aura at times. And we are very afraid of letting someone enter our aura, entering our personal space inside our home or wherever we work, etc. It's something that's seen so well in movies and TV shows, as well as in our own personal lives, if you pay attention. So here it's about, being bigger than what you are at the moment. If you're only thinking of the smaller picture, broaden your horizons, open up your mind, get out of the box, think larger. Don't limit yourself, in other words. Don't be hesitant to take a step in a new direction just because you're afraid of failing or just because you're afraid of losing. Don't always expect to win. That's another lesson I got from it. That you can't always win in the game of life or in sports or in anything else for that matter.
Right.
Sometimes there will be down days, and on those down days, chances are you may lose. You may not even have a down day. You may have your best day. But then your opponent or the competitors may have a better day than you, and they may do better than you. So, there's also other parameters that come into the equation. The weather, your luck, circumstances, corruption, and other such things. So there are days you may lose too. So you may fail, you may lose. Take it in your stride. Don't be afraid of trying out something new. Don't be afraid of going out there and playing again just because of those knocks that you receive along the way. I love the way it started, something like the fall in the river, as well as The violins were refreshing. The music wise,
it was beautiful. One of the rare rock songs, I think, which starts with the violin instead of any other
rock. Yeah, I'm talking about the start of the lyrics itself. Yeah, yeah. That the fall in the raw river, fall of the waterfall. You know, it's always giving you a picture of what's to come your way. And in a very profound manner. You must listen to it possibly 2-3 times, and I don't even remember those lines, but it struck me straight away because I knew this is how System of a Down kind of operates. So I did realize that there is going to be something right at the start. If I don't pay attention this time, I'm going to miss it. So it has happened in the past, the last 2 times. This time I didn't miss it. Your thoughts, Kirti, on the lyrics, your perspective, if there's anything at all. Just before you start off, maybe to refresh and jog your memory, I'll quickly run through the lyrics that I have here from the description box of another video on YouTube, right? So it's the title is obviously Ariel's. Life is a waterfall. We are one in the river and one again after the fall. Swimming through the void, we hear the word, we lose ourselves, but we find it all. Question mark. Because we are the ones that want to play, always want to go, but you never want to stay. We are the ones they want to choose. Always want to play, but you never want to lose. Ariel's in the sky. This is the chorus, the hook, the chorus. Call it what you will. Ariel's in the sky when you lose small mind. You free your life. Life is a waterfall. We drink from the river. Then we turn around and put up our walls. Swimming through the voids, we are the world. We are the word. We lose ourselves, but we find it all. Because we are the ones that want to play. Once again, that's repeated. Ariel's in the sky when you lose small mind, you free your life. Ariel's so up high when you free your eyes, eternal prize. What are your thoughts on all these words?
You know, these are more profound lyrics than what we may think of. When they're talking about we all want to play and all the time we want to play, the song is talking about the small mind games, the small tiny games, the ugly games that every single person keep playing with each other when we aren't different. We may build those walls on sand at the bank of the river. We do belong to the same river. But it is going to fall in no time. In no time those walls that you want to build and restrict others from are going to just collapse while you just turn back and see it. So it's talking about mainly about the mind games, the silly games, the pitiful games that people play all the time with others. For the sake of, I think, satisfaction, a lot of people do that. A lot of people do because they have no purpose in life. A lot of people do because they have nothing to look forward to. Because they don't make their goals, they don't make their life worth living and worth enjoying. And the song is dealing with all of that. Life is a waterfall. It should go on flowing, roaring. But at the same time, please be courteous. Please live and let live others as well. In the same stride, in the same flow, in the same river. You may go through a void, you may be alone at times, you may find yourself a bit isolated at times, but that comes with the journey. It's part of your journey. You don't have to get ugly. You don't have to get nasty. That's what the song is talking about.
Many of our first-time viewers may not know that Kirti is a pure reactor on YouTube. Apart from that, she is a counselor, she's a trainer, she's a parent. And she's a person who lives probably hundreds and thousands of miles away in India from most of our viewers and listeners. Assuming that. I would like your analysis, Kirti, on this one because I think you'll give another perspective, perhaps a lot different from mine, based on your experience, your background, your thought process. Ariel's in the sky when you lose small mind, you free your life. Yeah. This is the first part. Yeah. Ariel's in the sky when you lose small mind, you free your life. What is your thoughts on this?
It's as simple as it says. You know, look at the broadness around us. Just like the song is talking, connecting all the life, the way we live life, the philosophy of life with nature around. And giving an example through all of that. So when we are talking about aerials in the sky, the broadness in the sky, the horizon is so huge and so big. But our minds are so narrow. Sometimes so narrow, we only can see only certain things. We don't really see anything more. And I come across this now more than ever before. After coming on YouTube, after making our reaction videos, after reading so many comments, people treat you as if you're doing this the first time. This is not the first time. This is the 2001 time that I'm sitting here and I'm talking to you right now. You may be watching us for the first time and you realize that after 15 or 20 reactions, that what a blunder you made by judging me on the first go itself. And that's what it is talking about.
Let's get to the second part.
Let's broaden it, like the aliens.
Let's get to the second part because this is really interesting. It's a unique perspective by Kirti. Aerials so up high, when you free your eyes, eternal prize. Aerials so up high, when you free your eyes, eternal prize. What is your understanding of these words?
I see it as a vision. First they are talking about the mindset, now they are talking about the vision. Again, broaden it up, broaden it up. We are literally, when we look around.
When you say broaden, are you talking about opening your mind?
And
looking outside the box,
and
stepping out of your comfort zone, is
that.
It all that or does it mean something else?
No, it's all of that. It is all of that. It is having, actually, we do have our eyes. We look at everything. But do we have enough vision to view things as they are and not as we want them? We don't look at things the way they are. We look at things with our spectacles of judgments that we already have made.
So you're basically comparing most human beings to the horse races, the race horses, who have the blinders on, and due to that they can only see straight. Now the reason for that most of us know, is that they want to be focused, and also horses are very emotional. So if they see another horse taking over, they may give up too soon. So that will, they'll probably stop right there and meet with an accident with another horse behind, or they may lose it either ways. So basically, you're saying that all of us, we need to really, if we don't do it already, we need to open our eyes, we need to remove those spectacles of judgment that we are wearing, and we need to have a look at the bigger picture.
Yeah.
We need to be more open. Mm. Can you give an example of this so that people can understand what you're saying and what we are saying collectively on this channel a lot better?
A fitting example, wow, that would be something interesting to give. Let's say when we look at someone's is a festival, okay? Now, me coming from another background, me coming from another country, me coming from another culture, if I celebrate a particular festival, like there is Christmas in India, which is common between the West and East, I'll take that example because not everything that we have in common. So we celebrate Christmas in India and we also celebrate Christmas in the West. What happens in the West? In the West, it is the only festival, one of the major festivals.
One of the major festivals
of the year. It's something that people look forward to the entire year. And it's all lit up. Everything is roaring at that time. It's just fireworks all over the place. I mean, as far as the lighting and the streets are concerned. But in India, the scenario is a little bit different. Christmas time may be a bit lesser than the West. It will be a bit lesser than maybe Diwali. It will not be as grand as it is in the West. But if a person looking from the West sees and says these people are poor or something is wrong with them, why don't they celebrate it the way we do? They don't have that culture. Don't they know how it is? Don't you think it will be already he has a belief of his own place. And he's trying to put rubbish off on someone else.
And he also may have jumped to conclusions too quickly
based on his
prior assumptions and on the first sight.
They have to know we may have 365 festivals in a year.
Perhaps a lot more than that.
But maybe more.
Anyway, let's end this reaction. You made your example. You made your point. So did I.
I hope it was
we
clear.
We analyzed it. This is a masterpiece of sorts.
It is.
It's different. It's unique. It's a masterpiece in this genre of music, obviously. In different genres may not be, but in this genre. The one thing that I must critique or must highlight what I noticed is the repetition of the lyrics. It was very limited lyrics and then repetition of the chorus again and again. So just for that reason, I will rate the lyrics 7 on 10. It would have been 9 on 10 had it not been for those repetitions. For the music and the vocals, I'll give it 9 on 10. Your rating quickly, Kirti.
It's a 10 on 10 for me in all aspects.
Okay, goodbye.
Thanks for watching.